if everyone can gather around a little bit closer, I'll share the scriptures. You want to go ahead.
What camera?
Oh, right here.
Yeah. I will, yeah, I will.
So maybe somebody will help to get playing.
Video camera. Here are the headphones, you can get the sound. Put that in right here. All of these three cameras are going. You can
push start or stop. I don't want
to. Yeah,
stop
you don't have to worry about that.
This one's recording. See?
Okay.
So with each new baptism,
how many people are getting baptized?
Just press stop and start.
This is awesome.
Does that make sense? Yeah. I'll get you.
Now, just so no one's surprised. It screams like the Jello Girls, man.
The water is cold.
No, the water is beautiful.
You see that? It's hard to see.
Don't worry about that.
This tells you what's on that screen, kind of.
There are all kinds of little fish that are going to eat the dead skin off your
point that at them. Ready,
oh,
go.
It's awesome. It just tickles. They're just kissing your feet. So, I just wanted to warn you.
Think piranha.
No. It's just like they're kissing your feet.
Yeah, but, right.
No, it is. But here's the deal. Have you ever had that done? Have you ever done?
No.
Oh, yeah. All over in Europe, you pay big money to get a foot treatment by fish sucking on your foot. So here, it's for free with getting baptized. How awesome is that? But is this not a gorgeous place? So, Herzl and I worked hard to be able to get a beautiful baptism place. As I shared before, I don't go to that one place, it's just a cattle car. You're standing in line, there's thousands of people, you get 5 seconds. And the other one, the water has gotten so dirty down there, it's disgusting. So, you know, you just don't want to do it. So, years ago, I found this place. I haven't been here for a while. The water is way lower than what it has been. So we're going to, I'm going to share the scriptures. Then we're going to have the time of baptisms. And then we're going to give everyone like 20 minutes to go back and swim in the big pool back there as well. So, it's going to be an awesome blessing and opportunity, all right? So I want to share the scriptures right now. First off, in Matthew chapter 3, then Jesus came from Galilee to John at the Jordan to be baptized by him. And John tried to prevent him, saying, I have need to be baptized by you, and are you coming to me? And Jesus answered and said to him, permit it to be so now, for thus it is fitting for us to fulfill all righteousness. And then he allowed him. Then Jesus, when he had been baptized, came up immediately from the water. Behold, the heavens were opened to him, and he saw the Spirit of God descending like a dove and alighting upon him. And suddenly a voice came from heaven saying, this is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased. My friends, again, this water flows into the Jordan. So it's the same water that we would have got down there, only it's nice and beautiful and clear here. Actually, and I'm going to tell the story later on, just a couple miles up the road is the spring where this comes from. It's called En Harod, the spring of fear. Because this is where Gideon separated the soldiers as they drank. But this is that exact same water. And the place where it was is just a couple miles up. So we're going to tell the story here after we're through with baptisms and swimming. So Jesus came to the River Jordan to be baptized. And again, I always point out, did Jesus have any sins that needed washed away? No. So why did he get baptized? He gave it to us as an example that we should follow in his footsteps, and he did it at the beginning of the ministry. And for everyone that follows in his footsteps, that same voice, this is my beloved son, this is my beloved daughter, in whom I am well pleased. please. At the end of Jesus' ministry, in Matthew chapter 28, Jesus, when he's giving the Great Commission, go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to observe all things that I've commanded you. And lo, I am with you always until the end of the age. And again, if you've already been baptized, this is like if you're married, renewing your vows. You're not really getting married again. It's renewing that vow that you made. You're here in the Holy Land and the water that flows to the Jordan. When we get to Peter's first sermon, and I love this because when at Caesarea, if you remember, the Lord says, I'm going to give you the keys of the kingdom. And whatever you bind on earth is going to be bound in heaven. Whatever you loose on earth is going to be loosed in heaven. And Jesus, when he began his ministry, said, I've come to bind up the broken in heart. I've come to set the captives free. And for every single person that's here, they were a slave to sin. For every single person that's here, their heart has been broken and you've faced things in your life that have been very hurtful and destructive in your life. And guess what? We get to be the ones to share the gospel of binding up those who have been broken in heart and those who are bound by sin, of setting them free. And so Jesus, as he's preaching the very first sermon, there had never been a Christian sermon ever. It's the day of Pentecost and Peter is preaching. And again, before, just like with Cornelius later on, before he gets to the invitation, people's hearts are touched and they said, what must we do to be saved? And Peter replied, repent. That's where we turn around, we change direction, we turn to the Lord. So for all of us, baptism then becomes an outward declaration of what has happened in our heart and mind by making that great confession of faith that we studied yesterday up there in Caesarea Philippi. Then he said, and be baptized. Because baptism is an outward declaration of what Jesus has done in our hearts. When we go under the water, we're identifying with his death. But here's the other thing that we're saying. I'm willing to die to my old way of life. As we're brought up out of the water, it symbolizes that new life that the Lord gives us by the power of his Holy Spirit. And then he said, and receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. So repent, be baptized, receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. And I love this part. And that promise is for you, your children, for all who are far off, for all who the Lord our God will call. With many other words, he warned them and pleaded with them, save yourself from that this corrupt generation. 5,000 souls were added to them. So ever since that day, wherever there's been water, Christians have gathered together to commemorate, to make that declaration to God, to the devil, and to their family and friends. I am a believer in Jesus Christ. And I want to tell you, how special is this to have this place all to ourselves, and clean water, and running, and a little waterfall, and everything that makes it absolute. Let's give the Lord a hand. Now, when we get to the book of Romans, Romans chapter 6 is what I call the theology of baptism. What shall we say then? Shall we continue in sin that grace may abound? Certainly not. How is it that we who died to sin should live any longer in it? Or do you not know that as many of us were baptized into Christ, were baptized into his death? Therefore, we were buried with him through baptism into death, that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, even so, we should walk in the newness of life. For if we have been united together in the likeness of his death, certainly we shall also be in the likeness of his resurrection, knowing this, that our old man was crucified with him, that the body of sin might be done away with, that we should no longer be slaves of sin, for he who has died has been freed from sin. Amen?
Amen.
And so there's always two questions with baptism. Number one, do you believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of the living God?
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
That should be a more resounding
yes. Yes.
That Jesus is the Christ, the Son of the living God.
Yes. Yes.
And have you asked him into your heart to be your Lord?
Yes.
Yes.
All right. So let's worship. Justin's got his guitar. Now, for those that are getting baptized, if you want to get baptized together, your husband and wife will do that. So if there's somebody else you want to get baptized with, we can do that as well. Sarah, yeah. My imagined bag is back.
Yeah,
right,
yeah, our stuff is right there.
Stay in the water, but we want before anybody starts playing around, we'll wait until everyone gets baptized. If you want to get back out, you're welcome to. Besides Riley and Chris, who are going to help me baptize people, I could use a couple guys standing here to help people as they get down into the water. There's a few rocks here, that way no one slips or falls. Justin's going to lead us in worship, and he'd be the last to get baptized then. And then after that, we'll go play around with the big pools a little bit, and then I'll do one more teaching up there, because the stones as they lay out are exactly as they are up in Garage. And there's actually water here up there as well right now. So this way you'll be able to get the story of Gideon. So let's worship.